Good morning and welcome to our fifth grade graduation. We are so proud of all the students that we are presenting to you today as graduates of Shaw Elementary. You know, when I think about being a shining star, like 10 years ago, Ms. Voss and I decided that we were going to start this school and we decided we were going to be the shining stars. And what we were hoping for you is that when you come through this school, that you'll learn to shine. And you will learn to shine in ways like in your subject areas in school. Some of you have probably done that very well. We're very proud of you for that. We also want you to shine in your character. And the thing that I probably learned the most of being a mom of a student who's moved on to middle school now is that that character is what's going to help you be successful. So through Rise and Shine and all of your classes, you've learned great perseverance, dedication, and this group of students has done that so very well. We are very, very proud of you, and we cannot wait to see what you become someday. Yesterday, I don't know if any of you saw it, but we had a really neat opportunity to have our seniors that went through Shaw Elementary come back, and they walked the halls as graduates and talked about their future plans, and we can't wait in a few years to see you guys all come back and walk the halls with us as well. So congratulations, and thank you all parents for coming. Thank you for being partners with us and making this grade and this class a very special one.
Hi, I'm Jennifer Wiggins. I'm a fifth grade teacher, and I'm getting ready to introduce to you one of the young ladies that used to be a shot, well, she still is a shot star. Because once you're a star, you're always a star. Yesterday we had our senior walk, like Miss Beely said, and Miss Katie Dickey is a senior. She is a Shaw star, but she is graduating from high school, and she's here to talk to you about her experiences since being a Shaw star, and I know she's had many leadership roles at HAR-BER High School. Her whole family actually has played a really big part in our Shaw family, so please help me welcome Miss Katie Dickey.
Your mother and father taught you how to dress yourself and not eat like a monkey, and your teachers taught you that 2 + 2 = 4 and how to read. My fifth grade teacher was Miss Blythe, and she unfortunately had a stroke a few years ago and isn't a teacher anymore. This was the second year Shaw was open. I was fifth grade then. One of my favorite memories was reading Peter and the Starcatchers in the City of Ember. Still to this day, two of my favorite books. These books captured my imagination and took me to new worlds. Every now and then, I'll go back and read a couple pages to reflect on the storyline of the book. Sometimes when you're a grown-up, it's hard to remember to have an imagination and to have a magical outlook on life. So I want to encourage you to find something wonderful that inspires you. It could be a book, a favorite song, picture, or even your cat. Love on your inspiration and feed it as you get older. You'll be glad you did. So in just a few days, your time here will end in Shaw. Trust me when I say time flies. It seems like yesterday I was singing "Where the stars from the stars here are shining," and tomorrow I'll be singing hit that line, keep on going. Because tomorrow, children, I'm graduating too. You and I are in the same boat. I'm going to college, and you're going to middle school. Two big, big changes. Lucky for you, I've been to middle school. I doubt any of you kids have been to college yet, but if you have, meet me and we'll talk after this. I would love your advice. I'm going to tell you this now, and it's a lot of things, it's something that people don't really tell you. In middle school, kids are going to be mean. That's just the way life goes, especially in middle school. So just a word of advice, don't be that kid. Be that kid that goes and sits with a lonely boy or girl at the lunch table or helps another student with a tough word they don't understand. You never know what a simple act of kindness will do for another person. The kid you were nice to will remember that for the rest of their life. So enjoy the last few days with your friends, your teachers. You're going to all be fantastic Kelstrom Heroes, J.O. Kelly Knights, Helen Tyson Hornets, and Sonora Spartans. When I was in high school, I was in band, and that really kept me grounded throughout high school. This past year, I was given probably the most important leadership role in band. I was the lead and crew captain. I was responsible for about 15,000 to 20,000 or more dollars, $20,000 or more of equipment and instruments and all kinds of stuff. When I was a sophomore, my band director told me that he wouldn't even let me roll his keys up, roll his windows up. And then senior year, he couldn't believe that I was loading crew captain. Throughout your schooling, you're going to mature a lot. You're going to have heartaches, and you're going to have probably the best times of your life. So that's it. Congratulations, you guys.
Thank you. Mr. Schmidt has a family of four, including two children and a wife. They moved from St. Louis 2 years ago. Mr. Schmidt loves nature and preaching every Sunday morning at Northwest Arkansas Church of Christ. Now please help me welcome Mr. Schmidt.
Thank you, Cooper. Well, good morning. As Cooper said, my name is Tim Schmidt, and I have the privilege of serving as a minister here in Northwest Arkansas. I'm also a soccer coach for the Springdale Wildcats, second and third grade girls. A few of them are in here this morning as well. I'm mostly known around here as JT's dad, and I've had a great time getting to know many of you. We just came back from the fifth grade overnight field trip, which I'm still itching from. I've got bites all over my legs. But you know, the biggest thing I think I'm most proud of is just being JT's dad. And I'm super proud of all of you guys. Honored to speak with you for a few minutes this morning. But you know, as you graduate from the fifth grade, I want you to know you've worked hard, and hard work pays off. Shaw Stars, you are something special. You've been blessed to be part of the Willis D. Shaw Elementary family. You have teachers who care about you. I've seen that. I've seen your teachers going above and beyond what teachers need to do. It's not just their job, it's a passion for them to take care of you guys and to teach you. Your principals, your coaches, others who care about you. You're a part of a community that cares about you. Your parents, your grandparents, your siblings. Shaw Stars, you are surrounded by people who have gone above and beyond to help you learn and to help you grow. You know, when I was a kid, I was a part of something special at my elementary school. I went to kindergarten 37 years ago, and I still keep in touch with my kindergarten teacher. She's in her 90s now. Her name's Mrs. Robin. She's back in St. Louis. And right before we moved here, I went and saw her and spent some time with her. And it was amazing. Even at 90-something years old, she still remembers her students. She still has special memories of her time at the elementary school. I still remember elementary school. I remember going to school carnivals. I remember being in the library club. Mrs. Gadbury, I was in the library club. Yeah. I remember playing with our Star Wars action figures. That was the first time around for Star Wars. Out on the playground, we played with those action figures. I remember my friend Mario kicking home runs in kickball. He always wanted to be on Mario's team. I remember another friend, Ricky, in kindergarten. He would eat his crayons, and he told us the purple ones tasted the best. Don't eat crayons, okay? They're not good for you. But I was privileged to be part of something special when I was in elementary school. And you guys are part of something special. I know that you're going to have memories from Shaw Elementary that you will have for a lifetime. JT's mom and I are so thankful that our kids get to be part of the Shaw family. We're grateful. To all the teachers, principals, staff, volunteers, we're grateful for what you've done for these kids. Shaw Stars, you've been surrounded by a community of people that want to help you be your best. And now you need to continue to surround yourself with people that will help you be your best. You need to be a friend to others and help them be their best. Fifth graders, you are Shaw Stars. I want to talk for just a minute about stars. Have you ever gone outside late at night, just looked up at the stars? You just stop and pause and just everything is quiet. You look up and you see those stars. I love going outside at night, looking up, watching the stars. And at first you notice one or two bright stars. And then you start to notice dozens of stars. And then hundreds of stars. And then thousands of stars in the night sky. And then literally there are millions of stars. Sometimes if you're lucky, you might even catch a glimpse of a shooting star, a meteorite. You know, stars are gathered into galaxies. And our galaxy is called the Milky Way. It's believed that there's over 100 billion stars just in our galaxy. That's a one with 11 zeros after it. So I want to know, can I get a volunteer to count the stars just in our galaxy? Anyone want to volunteer for that? Someone that's really good at math? Okay, we have one over there. All right. So, you know, if you started counting the stars just in our galaxy, if you counted one star per second, it would take you 3,170 years just to count those stars in our galaxy. Do I still have a volunteer? Scientists estimate beyond our galaxy that there's billions of So that means there's just billions and billions and billions of stars out there. You know, while there are so many stars, each star has its place. Each star is special. Each star was created. Each star has a name. Each star is unique. Did you know that no two stars are exactly the same? Just like you guys. No two stars are exactly the same size. Many stars support their own solar system of planets and moons. Each star, just like you, is special. You know, back before GPS and satellites, the sailors would use the stars to navigate. They would go out at night and they could tell where they were in the world just based on the stars. Every star was important to them. Every night the stars came out. When it was cloudy or stormy, they couldn't see where they were going because they didn't have the stars to show them the way. Our own sun is a star. Did you know that without the sun, the gravitational pull that holds the Earth in, without that, we would just fly off into space? Without the sun, without the light and heat it produces, we could not live. Plants would not grow, we would freeze. We even get vitamin D from the sun. The sun is a special star. And if you're like me, sometimes, you know, just being one of a billion stars, we can feel like that, like we're just one of many. Just one of the crowd, but let me tell you something, Shaw Stars, that's not the case. You are a special star. You have a special place. You have a role in this world. You were created for something special. Some of you may go on to be teachers, doctors, mechanics. I know we have a lot of police officers in this crowd, right? And I feel very safe knowing how many of you guys want to be police officers. You may protect others by doing just that, or being in the army, being a firefighter. Many of you one day will be parents, and you'll be sitting in this crowd. Many of you will be grandparents. You will have an impact on the lives of so many people. You have a special place in this world. What will your role be? How will you shine? How will your light impact those around you? Over the next several years, as you finish school, what dreams will you have? Shaw Stars, I want to encourage you to dream. But don't just dream. Dream big. Fifth graders, you've already been shining bright. It's time to keep shining. It is time to dream big. It is time to shine brighter. Time to shine like stars. Time to shine like Shaw Stars. Thank you.
Well, thank you, Mr. Schmidt, for those wonderful words. And at this time, I'd like to introduce you to one of our fifth grade teachers, Ms. Jennifer Wiggins, who has some words to share.
Relax, guys, I'm not gonna sing. I know you're disappointed. All right, so it's finally here. It's the day y'all have been waiting for. Okay. I know you guys are ready. In a little bit, you guys are going to hear a song. It's a really good song. It's by Nicole Nordeman. It's called Slow Down. And I kind of printed the lyrics. I'm not going to sing them. I'm going to say them. But in the lyrics, it says, "Won't you stay here a minute more? I know you want to walk through the door, but it's all too fast. Let's make it last a little while. I pointed to the sky, and now you want to fly. I am your biggest fan. I hope you know I am." So Mrs. Taylor, Ms. Farrell, and myself, we all know that you guys are ready. But if we're honest, we find ourselves wishing you could stay a moment more. We, along with all these people in this room, we are your biggest fans. So we pointed you to the sky. So Ms. Taylor, myself, Ms. Farrell, we've taught you a little bit about writing, literary devices, and volume. So we might leave you with one last lesson. Do you have your notebook? Okay. So your life, your story, is like a cube, right? And your time at Shaw, your story at Shaw, is the base. This is where you learn to read, to write, multiply, character, all those things we've talked about this morning. And now it's time for the volume, to build your capacity. And we are so excited for you to finish your story. So, you ready to fly?
Next year, I'm gonna make Ms. Williams go after I do anything. She does this to me every year. All right, we're gonna begin with Ms. Wiggins' class. And we have saved you from coming back again. So we're combining our graduation with our Shining Star celebration for fourth quarter. So we'll be giving out their awards as we go. First, Luke Adams. He's receiving the Academic Star and Reading and Math Star Awards. Piper Alexander, Academic Star winner. Galatia Andrew, Academic Star winner. Ashley Ariza, Academic Star and Shining Star Character Award. Cole Carlton, Academic Star and Reading Star winner. Natalie Carter, Academic Star and Reading Star winner. Dylan Charles, Academic Star, Reading and Math Star Award. Savannah Cheney, Academic Star, Reading and Math Star Award. Grace Collins, Academic Star, Reading and Math Star, and Shining Star Character. Eric Corona, Academic Star winner. Brooklyn Farmer, Academic Star and Reading and Math Star winner. Tyler Grindstaff, Academic Star, Reading and Math Star, and Shining Star Character. Noah Hendren, Perfect Attendance and Academic Star Award. Nathan Hopkins, Academic Star in Reading and Math Star Awards. Cooper Horn, Perfect Attendance, Academic Star, and Reading and Math Star Awards. Kinsley Huber, Academic Star, and Reading Star winner. Billy Ibarra, Academic Star winner. Justin Johnson, Academic Star.
Shannon Johnson, academic star and shining star character. Marissa Lilly, Sitlali Martinez, Shining Star Character Award. Joey Morris, Academic Star and Shining Star Character Award. Kaylani Niziel, Academic Star, Reading and Math Star. Caitlin Reynolds, HAR-BER, Academic Award, Reading and Math Star Award, and Shining Star Character. Nicole Tillery, Perfect Attendance and Academic Star. Kiana Wittenberg, Academic Star and Reading Star Award. Aiden Lathrop in Ms. McCaslin's class. And Evelyn Ritter, let's give a big congratulations to Ms. Wiggins and Mr. Castle's students. Next up, we're going to graduate Ms. Farrell's students. Lana Blair. Winter Clampett, Academic Star, Reading Star, and Math Star. Evan Culpepper, Academic Star, and Reading Star. Caden Davenport, Academic Star winner. Kevin Davis, Academic Star and Math Star Award. Jared Gadberry, Academic Star, Reading and Math Star, and Perfect Attendance. Yeah. Melissa Garnica, academic star, reading star, math star, perfect attendance, and shining star character. Donovan Hash, academic star, reading and math star, and perfect attendance. Ashlyn Hodge, academic star and reading star award. Noah Holmes, academic star, reading star, and math star award. She's had a few Holmes boys. Rita Hudson, academic star, reading and math star, and shining star character. Danielle Huff, academic star winner. Sydney Johnson, academic star and reading star awards. Riley Jordan, perfect attendance. Mary Catherine Ledbetter, Academic Star Award. Emily Marquez, Academic Star and Reading Star Award. Luis Mata, Reading Star and Math Star Award. Brooklyn McCreary, Academic Star, Reading and Math Star, and Perfect Attendance. Blake Messino, academic star, reading and math star, and perfect attendance. Brooklyn Phillips, perfect attendance award. Luis Rodriguez, perfect attendance and shining star character. Stacy Roman, shining star character award. JT Schmidt, academic star, reading and math star. Sophie Simmons, academic star, reading and math star, and shining star character. Dawson Welch, academic star, reading and math star. Congratulations to Ms. Farrell students. Now we're going to recognize Ms. Taylor's students. We'll begin with Claire Albritton, Academic Star and Reading and Math Star Awards. Leslie Barroso, Academic Star. Catherine Bodris, Academic Star. Lainey Bibbin, Academic Star and Reading and Math Star. Kenda Burkett, Academic Star, Reading and Math Star. Grant Courtney, Academic Star, Reading and Math Star. Miller Dawson, Academic Star winner. Daxton Evans, Academic Star and Reading Star Award. Giovanni Herrera, Academic Star Award. Emma Holt, Academic Star, Reading and Math Star. Ella Hudson, Academic Star, Reading and Math Star. Abby Kelly, Academic Star Award. Isaiah Lilly, Academic Star. Logan Mills, Academic Star. Colin Mounts, Academic Star, Reading and Math Star. Corbin Mullen, Academic Star, Reading and Math Star. Alex Murillo, Academic Star. Connor Penalto, Academic Star, Reading and Math Star. Rylan Potts, Academic Star, Reading and Math Star. Ben Reinebo, Academic Star, Reading and Math Star. Melissa Rodriguez, Academic Star, Reading and Math Star. Leah Santos, Academic Star. Woo! Mackenzie Smith, Academic Star. Cody Sparks, Academic Star Award. Dylan Steinauer, Academic Star, Reading and Math Star. Cole Thompson, Academic Star, Reading and Math Star. Roger Trujillo, Academic Star, Reading and Math Star. And Cameron White, Academic Star Award. Let's give another big hand to all of our graduates. We're so proud of them.
We had a technical difficulty and we didn't get to see Ryland's slide, so Ms. Herrera is going to pull that up right now. Ryland, we love you. Speaking of Ms. Herrera, let's all give Ms. Herrera a big round of applause. She makes every celebration just so special with the music and just the pictures. There's nothing like getting to see it for yourself. Well, we're at the point now where I have some special awards to give, and teachers, if I can have y'all come back up. This actually is the Presidential Award, and so I have a letter from the President to read, and then we have students that we're gonna recognize that have had all A's over the past few years, and even A's and B's. If you've been able to go above and beyond what we've expected of you at grade level work, then we want to recognize you for that. Not only do we want to recognize you for your hard work now, but we want to put that vision in your mind that from here on out, that's what's expected of you, okay? This excellence that we are celebrating today, we're expecting that to be carried on throughout your years of education, okay? So this is from the President. Please accept my congratulations on receiving the President's Education Award. I commend you for the powerful example you have set for your family, friends, and peers, and it is a privilege to join in recognizing your achievement. Our country faces great challenges, and we will overcome them if we all work together and for a common purpose. No matter who we are or how old we may be, America looks to students like you, whose dreams and determination know no bounds, to strengthen our communities and help drive our nation forward. Your commitment to your education demonstrates the creativity and energy that will chart the course of our unwritten history, allowing us to reimagine reality and seek new frontiers. I'm inspired by your motivation and work ethic, and it gives me great hope to know our future will be written by ambitious young people like you. I encourage you to continue working hard and aiming high, and I wish you all the best. Barack Obama. Okay, so that is our President's letter, which you will receive. Ms. Beely, I'll let you hand out the letters. And then we're going to first recognize those people that have earned the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence. And this was because you were able to attain all A's through your fourth and fifth grade years, actually. Okay, first up, Melissa Garnica. Brooklyn McCreary. Lainey Bivin, Ella Hudson, Dylan Steinauer, Luke Adams, Savannah Chaney, Grace Collins, oh, I didn't tell y'all this, but we really would like to get a picture of all of you. So if you've already sat back down, if you'll go ahead and come stand over here, we'll get you all to come up on the stage together. Just go over here and stand up. Tyler Grindstaff. Cooper Horn. Benjamin McQuarrie. Kalani Niziel and Ezra Tarver. Give them one big round, another round of applause. The next award goes is the Presidential Award for Educational Achievement, and it goes to students that have achieved A's and B's, going still above and beyond grade level expectations. So we want to recognize these people as well. So why don't you all, when you get your certificate, if you'll go and just stand on the bottom row of the risers. We'll be ready for our picture. Case Chambliss, Kevin Davis, Jared Gadberry, Donovan Hash, Ashlyn Hodge, Noah Holmes, Rita Hudson, Sydney Johnson, Emily Marquez, Luis Mata, Blake Messino, JT Schmidt, Sophie Simmons, Brooklyn Farmer, Cole Carlton, Natalie Carter, Dylan Charles, Nathan Hopkins, Claire Albritton, Ken the Burkett. Grant Courtney. Dakota Evans. I have to tell you in between times, this is not like any other class we've ever had. It's amazing what you all have been able to accomplish and attain over the years. Emma Holt. Colin Mounts. Corbin Mullen. Connor Penalto. Rylan Potts. Alex Murillo. Ben Rynabo. Melissa Rodriguez. Mackenzie Smith. Cole Thompson. Roger Trujillo. And Cameron White. All right. So quite a crew that have been able to go above and beyond grade level expectations for their fourth and fifth grade years. Let's give them another big round of applause. So parents, a word as they're getting organized, a word of encouragement for you. If your students were one of these that were chosen for the Presidential Award, the very best thing research tells us that you can do to encourage and enrich is to get them hooked on reading. So they need to be reading books. They need to be spending time every day reading. Ms. Gadbury will amen me on that. Boys and girls that didn't receive the Presidential Award but have received many other awards, the same thing goes for you. Reading is the most powerful thing that you can do to enrich yourself or to remediate, to get you where you need to be. So I hope that as you leave Shaw Elementary, you can just truly remember the power behind that reading and just taking time to do it, getting in a habit of reading, making that be just a daily practice. And I bet if I were to ask this for a show of hands, there would be adults in this audience that would say to this day, there's not a day that goes by that we don't spend time reading. Adults, grandparents, parents, raise your hand if that's you. If you spend time reading every single day, let me see your hands. So boys and girls, you understand how important that is. Okay. So proud of each and every one of you, and just help us as we reflect with a few of the great memories that we've had today or this throughout the years at Shaw Elementary.
Thank you.
congratulations to the class of 2016 Willis D. Shaw Elementary's fifth grade.
So very proud of you, and I hope you felt very supported this morning with all the great words of wisdom that have come your way. We're going to have an awesome afternoon, parents. Thank you for joining us, and thank you for sharing your kiddos with us over the years. We love them so much, and I know they're going to do great things. Can't wait to see them come back through the halls and walk the halls in their caps and gowns all too soon. We're going to take a few minutes to kind of let you take pictures. And boys and girls, do you hear me? You're going to take pictures with your parents if they want pictures. You're not going to change your clothes until they're ready for you. So we have about 15 minutes that we can do that in here before lunch starts. And then they have an exciting afternoon planned. They're going to have pizza. Yes, we're going to have it here at school because of the rain. But then they're going to head on to High Rise and have a great time. And they'll see you this afternoon then. So thanks again for coming and joining us and helping us celebrate your kiddos.